Hey, what's going on, folks? So, it's been a few months and I haven't kept you up to date on everything. One, because I kind of got behind, and in the hustle and bustle, I've lost so many accessories to these GoPros and everything that I film with, and I've had to order a bunch of new stuff. And then I've had to order some new stuff for the pet-friendly remodel, and just getting it in it's almost impossible these days. So we have done some stuff, and I'm going to catch you up. I'm not sure where we're at. But like I said, we wanted to make this a place where people could stay when they come to events, when we host workshops, handler courses, or even for our scent work group that trains. We have a full house that we can hide stuff in. So I'll just kind of catch you up to speed and we'll go from there. What I'm going to do from here on out is I'm just going to give you one DIY every video. So today we're going to try something new that I saw online. We'll see if it works. All right, so we'll start with, obviously, we had to replace the storm door. It's a custom order, so it took us a few weeks to get in. What you will notice differently is in this porch, we had a lot of wood. So we wanted something because Kentucky weather's horrible. It rains, it's muddy, and dogs stay just dusty and dirty all winter long. We went with, it's actually trim coil pack. So we were able to cut it and bend it, and we still have to go in here and silicone it. But, you know, we're hoping that it's just easy to wipe down and it'll give a clean appearance. We did pull up the carpet. I was going to just paint the concrete. I kind of dug that look. Unfortunately, as we progress, we see right here a lot of cracks. So we will be covering that up with vinyl plank. And the back wall, what do we do with this? So, you know, my first thought was let's do shiplap, but I was afraid that shiplap would eventually get like this and it would just be dated and nobody wants it in the future, and then we're redoing that. I was going to pull this off, maybe just put some siding in here since we're redoing the siding on the outside. But then I saw a video online, and what we're going to do today is we're going to see if we can't prep this and make it work. But there was some step-by-step instruction from a painting company that said you can actually make this look like drywall. So we're going to try that out and see how it works. Since we only have a small spot to work with, you know, a couple small spots, we're going to see if we can make that work. Roughed everything up, kind of smoothed out the little nail holes. I do need to get a punch and kind of sink in a few of these paneling nails a little bit more. Then I'm going to wipe this down and then take a wet cloth and knock off the extra dust. And then we will start with the primer. We've got it sanded, and we've sanded it down a little bit. I wiped it off with just a dry cloth, just knocked off the dust, and then took a damp rag and went over it and got off the rest of the dust. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take some primer, and I actually just ran down to my local hardware store and got this stuff called 123 Bullseye, and I'm going to start off by just applying primer to these little grooves. And that's what I'm going to do first. I'm going to apply primer to these little grooves. I'm going to let that sit. Actually, I've got to backtrack. I'm going to have to put some painter's tape up here. But I'm going to go ahead and get started and let you see that. And then we'll sit and come back to the next step. Make sure these nails were in there flush. There's actually one I've got to work on. Applied the primer just to these grooves. And the next step is I'm going to take some spackling and just fill them in. Once the spackling sets up, I'll come back and I'll lightly sand it. but I'll kind of start the process and let you follow along. Disclaimer, I'm not a drywall guy. Every time I try to do drywall, I've really jacked it up. So my thought process is I'm going to keep this real thin. I'm going to let it dry. I just wanted to fill in this first seam, see how it does. I'll hit it real lightly, and then I'll come back with another light run of spackle and see if that does it. I can actually see it working, but like I said, I'm not a drywall guy, so it's going to be one of those things where I have to kind of play this out, but I can definitely see that this is possible. All right, so like I said, I'm not a drywall guy. I tried to keep them as light as possible just to fill in the grooves. I'm going to let it dry, and I'm going to come back and sand it smooth, and then I'm going to do a second coat of this, and if that looks good, then we'll apply primer tomorrow. And once that dries, I will put on a couple coats of paint. So fingers crossed, I think this may actually be doable.
Ooh.
So I may have underestimated this a little bit. Maybe I got a little bit too carried away with the spackle, but you want it smooth and it's feeling pretty good. There's a few rough spots. It's coming along, not drying as fast as possible as I possibly would like, but I tell you what, I've got a whole new respect for people that do drywall. I understand why most of those guys are skinny now. This is a lot of work. All right, so day two. I did not film me putting the primer on it. I talked about the primer. I did put two coats of primer on this because I think paneling just absorbs it. The first coat was really light. I kind of wanted it to almost look like a base layer paint. And here we are, one coat of paint in, and voila. It does look like drywall. Now, I did make it a little bit harder than it needs to be. I need to focus just, you know, first round, just filling in the grooves, lightly sanding it, and then going back and filling it in again, lightly sanding it. I also ran across some other steps that said if you use a darker color, it kind of hides more, but it overall does look pretty good. There's a couple little spots, but this is the porch, and I wanted to try everything out on the porch because the porch doesn't have to be perfect. So if I kind of get the feel of this, then I will go ahead and do a couple other rooms in the house because the hallway and the living room has paneling. They're in great shape, but, you know, and it'll save you. If you're in this situation, you buy an old house, literally by the time you pull this down, rehang sheetrock, finish the sheetrock, and then paint, you're thousands of dollars into a project. So we're definitely going to try this out. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure you like and subscribe. I'll show you a little bit of a clip of what's kind of drug this whole weekend out, a major problem we got into. Just a little behind the scenes, because that's the kind of stuff you're going to see on Patreon. We're going to start pushing Patreon more. We're also going to start doing the premium YouTube stuff, the memberships where you get custom badges and emojis and things just specific for this channel. But thank you, folks. Like and subscribe. Use that link below for Amazon, all your purchases. It just helps us put out more content, and we're going to keep putting out more and more content. Travel videos, DIY videos, obedience, protection, obviously detection and scent work, and, you know, smash that button, and we'll see you next week. All right, folks. So, like I said, don't forget to like and subscribe. Follow us on Patreon. I'm going to leave you with this, because the reason we pulled an all-nighter was trying to update the bathroom. I wasn't even going to put the bathroom in the video series, but I wanted to do more with what we had. So I pulled out the 1970s, early 80s base tub. And when we did, we discovered that not only down here were, and I'll post a picture, was there a leak from the hot water heater that had been leaking since God knows when. And we're just now getting into the meat and potatoes. But
you'll see all the new subfloor in there. The subfloor was bad. We had to replace that, and we had to replace four floor joists. So we really got into a heck of a mess. But, you know, the hardest part, I feel like, is behind us, and maybe we can get this wrapped up today, at least with the flooring and shower and new hot water heater, and then we'll finish out the part of the bathroom that's just cosmetic. So there it is, folks. Thank you for another video. Like I said, I'm gonna start documenting more and more of my business behind the scenes, and definitely more scent work, and even some other stuff as we push into the other sports that we've done in the past. But thank you again, folks, and I will see you next week.